So that all the Jews would turn away from the broken cisterns back to the fountain and say, he's enough. He promised all these glorious things to us. Let's take him as our treasure and not that. And the second thing he came to do was for the Gentiles in verse 9. And for the Gentiles he came so that they might glorify God for his mercy. So you got the integrity and the truthfulness and the righteousness and the trustworthiness of God in verse 8, born out for the Jews, and you've got the glory of God born out for the Gentiles through mercy. And beware, Gentiles, beware lest you take the gift of mercy and walk away from the giver. Because this text says, God did not come for that to happen. God did not send Jesus into the world so that you might take the forgiveness of sins and walk away from God with forgiveness. If you do, you're not saved. Christians love God. Christians love Christ. Christians hold to a person. They love a person. God Almighty, he is their treasure, he is their life, he's their hope, he's their all. And they glorify him for his gifts. They don't take his gifts and leave him. They don't say, oh good, I'm forgiveness, more TV, more money, more sex, good, I'm forgiven, see you God. That's not what this text says. Christ came into the world for the Gentiles to glorify God for his mercy, which means, yes, you take the gift. I extend it to everybody in this room this morning. God will forgive you for trampling his glory in the dirt the last 53 years of my life. And if you see that for what it really is, that God and that forgiveness and that imputed righteousness and that sanctifying power and that vindication of God's glory for his people, if you see that, you will love that God. He will be your treasure. He will be your all. He'll be your hope. He will be everything to you. And you will glorify him. You will not be able to cease saying, I praise you, I love you. I want to think, feel, and act in ways that show you are my treasure. In other words, evil begins to be overcome, and a new holiness begins to come in, and the new person in Christ is one who begins to feel and begins to think and begins to do things that highlight the worth of God and the all-satisfying beauty of God.